We've got a lot of ingredients with which to work today, John. And I do want to show you a few viewer photos that were sent in to us of that trace of snow in Teller County. And for some areas, perhaps you got a little bit more than a trace of snow. This was sent in to us from Linda in Florissant. You can see some of the pumpkins now have some fresh frosting of that white stuff. This is of some of the snowy rooftops in Woodland Park. We got several others. This one also in Florissant. In New Mulo State Park, we did also get a bit of a trace of snow. And take a look at some of the visitors atop Pikes Peak earlier this morning from our COG railway camera. That was very impressive. We'll continue to see a bit of some spotty snow for some of the mountains as we go throughout the afternoon and into the early evening. There will also be some scattered showers. That's what we're seeing right now on Live HD Doppler radar. However, we are seeing primarily these showers taking place south of Highway 50, and that's going to be our story as we go throughout the afternoon. Walsenburg and Trinidad, you're experiencing some light rain right now, and as you look off to the west, for some of the southern mountains, we have a rain and snow mix. Stretching out into east Los Angeles County, we also have some light rain. But for Colorado Springs and Pueblo, right now we're staying nice and dry. At least if there is any sort of drizzle for those areas, it's not getting picked up on Doppler. Right now, those temperatures are cool, and that's a big part of our weather story today. We're only at 48 for the Colorado Springs Airport, 54 for the Pueblo Airport, with the 30s and the 40s for some of the mountains. Let's take this neighborhood to neighborhood now. Northern El Paso County, you're in the upper 30s to mid 40s. Some of the mid 40s for I-25 at Garden of the Gods. Pueblo West, you've just crested into the low 50s with some of the 30s in place for Walsenburg through Trinidad. As for what to expect throughout the rest of the day, here's a look at 2:30. You see primarily these showers taking place south of Highway 50 and also for the southeastern slice of the state. Near the Colorado-Kansas state line and also near the Colorado-New Mexico state line, those are going to be the areas that will see some of the heaviest rain later on today. But a look at 8:30 shows you that primarily a lot of these showers will have cleared up and will stick with partly to mostly clear skies as we go throughout the overnight hours. It's going to be so cool overnight. The National Weather Service has issued these frost advisories that last from 3 to 9 o'clock. It includes the I-25 corridor stretching out into the eastern plains. So that's a look at throughout the rest of the afternoon and overnight. But what about Halloween? Well, trick-or-treaters might need to grab the coat. Temperatures will be in the 40s to the 50s, but overall, not very scary. And guess what? We'll stay dry, and things will actually be pretty mild. It's going to be great for getting outside and collecting some candy, doing any sort of outdoor family activities. Now, all the way through the weekend and start of next work week, we keep things dry. In fact, Sunday into Monday, temperatures will rebound to the upper 60s. Next Wednesday all the way through Friday morning, we have the possibility for a bit of a rain and snow mix, with temperatures next Thursday and Friday dropping to the upper 40s. Tomorrow for Halloween in Pueblo will be at 68 degrees. On Sunday, we'll be in the mid 70s. Low 70s we go on Monday, still staying so pleasant out there. We stay dry in the Steel City through Wednesday, but Thursday and Friday things will look a little bit more wet and unsettled, with those temperatures dipping to the mid 50s. Tomorrow in Canyon City, 65 will be the high temperature, and we'll actually stick with a good amount of sunshine. It's going to be quite a contrast to what we're seeing today. Kind of typical Colorado weather for you. We stay dry and mild through Wednesday before dropping those temperatures next Thursday and Friday, and adding in some more spotty showers. 50 tomorrow for Teller County. Teller County will also get in on some of that sunshine. Quite a contrast as well to some of the snow that you've seen today. Sunday all the way through Tuesday, we have a mixture of sunshine and clouds with a bit of a rain and snow mix on tap Wednesday through Friday morning. Remember that that extended forecast could still change, and we'll keep a very close eye on it for you. We'll have a look at those overnight lows and much more for you coming up in the next little bit.
And you did not bring your puffy jacket today.
Oh.
I did not, because the morning temperatures weren't as bad as what we've seen recently, but this afternoon, I'm glad I still have my gloves with me.
All right. Thanks, Abby. Mm-hmm. The New York Mets are back home today.